What is realism in film? Is it the objective portrayal of reality on screen? Can reality even be trapped in a medium form? The Nobel Prize winner Werner Heisenberg, in his Uncertainty Principle, explains how it is impossible to define a given phenomenon in an objective and precise way, because by observing the phenomenon itself, you inevitably modify it. If only by witnessing a given event we change it, what shall we infer about the process of filmmaking? As we know, every aspect of filming is a manipulation of reality. From the screenplay to the lighting, from the acting to the editing, every aspect of this art adds an element of inauthenticity. So, what is realism in film? As Christian Metz said in his book Film Language, A Semiotic of Cinema, realism is not reality. What is it then? As far as I'm concerned, we can define realism as the effort of seizing reality and represent it on screen. To what extent does this movie recall reality? I would like to apply this concept to Rossellini's movie Rome Open City. Can Rome Open City be defined realist? And if so, why? To do this, I will analyze the last 5-minute sequence of the film, where the character Don Pietro is executed by the Nazis' troops. In my opinion, Rome Open City is not only close to reality, but it is a cruel vivisection of reality itself. This might sound as an arguable statement to many people. As a matter of fact, a lot of people argued with me, saying that almost every scene in the movie comes across as staged and melodramatic. Let's take into consideration this interaction between a soldier and the general of the German army.
Esatto. Sono in ritardo.
Già, sono in ritardo.
Una sigaretta?
Grazie.
Fiammifero?
I admit that for a contemporary watcher, this exchange of lines may come across as mechanical, lacking spontaneity. But let me show you something.
Perché hai agito così?
Ma non cercare di sapere. Tu ora sei felice, tranquillo. Io non avrei potuto offrirti nulla di quello che tu oggi hai. Il successo, la fortuna, l'amore.
No, tu devi spiegarti, parla.
This was La Canzone dell'Amore, a film by Gennaro Righelli, produced in 1930. This was what the Italian audience was accustomed to. In fact, Rossellini was widely criticized for his stylistic approach, which seemed to deviate too much from the canonic cinematographic standard, overplay acting and a general theatrical approach. So, although I understand where these arguments come from, I believe that too often we watch a movie for what we are and not for what the movie is. In other words, we see the movie through our mental frame rather than from an objective point of view. Especially when it comes to older movies, I believe we should step back from our set of notions of human beings living the wealthy part of the world in the 21st century and put the movie in an historical perspective. Furthermore, the reason why we can compare films like Rome Open City to modern realist films like Red Road or Movenkalr is because somebody like Rossellini had the courage to break the habits and bring something new to the table.
Venga, coraggio.
Oh, non è difficile morire bene. Difficile vivere bene.
Now, I would like to discuss the main reason why I consider Rome Open City a cruel portrait of reality. This element may not be found in the film language or in the stylistic choice, but behind the reasons why this film was made. Rome Open City has a burning urgency to be told. Rossellini began to shoot his movie 2 months after Rome had been liberated from the Nazis' occupation. He essentially shot his film on the ashes of the destroyed city. There was a military convention called Aja Convention, which stated that it wasn't allowed to bomb or attack an undefended city. Rome, however, was bombed, destroyed, and violated in every possible manner. Somebody had to tell this story, a story of abuse and hatred, a plague that didn't stop in front of nor woman or child, a plague that neglected every human right, leaving an inalienable scar in our history. Statistics show that from the start of the war in 1940 to Allies' liberation in 1945, only in Italy more than 37,000 civil partisans died in the attempt of resisting the Nazis' occupation. So, to come back to my first statement, does this film recall reality? We may argue that it might not be an accurate historical portrait or that there's too much room left for comedy considering the given situation. But after all, what is more real than this? The total absence of an happy ending, the death of hope, the burial of any value, that's exactly what people felt after the horrors experienced in the Second World War. Somebody had to tell these feelings, and I believe that Rossellini did it greatly. Not only brought innovation to the Italian film scene, but he brought to life a film which had the urgency to be burned and tell something. Rome Open City has something more relevant in the discussion of realism than any acting approach or stylistic choice. That something is a strong underlining emotional credibility. This, in my opinion, is more important than the attempt of seizing reality only by the exterior imitation of the real world, which, as I said in the beginning, is a vain practice anyway, since filmmaking is inevitably a process of inauthenticity. I think that the palpable emotional urgency on which Rome Open City is based gives the movie something more real than a handheld camera or a naturalistic dialogue can ever give. It gives the movie a soul.